Hello and welcome. This is a video over the general things with player on ports, that with information on what's good to unlock and such. First off, to use player on ports fully, you need level 90 in fishing, herb lore, prayer, runecrafting, thieving, and slayer. But to use the port generally, you just need one of those to be in level 90. And some of the rewards you do need level 90 in: smithing, fletching, cooking, crafting, and runecrafting. So, player on ports is located at the north edge of Port Sarum near the bar, and it's a quick trip from either the Lodestone or using the Explorer's Ring 3 or higher. So, once you get here, just head on through the portal, and you'll immediately see the partner standing right here around the side of the portal. So, talking to him will open a cutscene, and after that you'll have to go to speak with the Navigator, which on screen now is a map of the player on ports. Thank you, Jagex, for that one. So, before we go any further on talking to the, talking to the Navigator, there is a girl here named Meg, and you can send her off. If you don't have level 90 in any skills, she'll be right about here. Otherwise, she'll be over here to the side. So pretty much what you'll need to do then is actually speak to her, go through some chat options. She'll basically be like your fangirl. You do have the option to tell her to shut up, like Family Guy. So the classic Shut Up Meg will be there. So send her off and she'll come back once a week. It'll be the same time that they reset penguins, etc. So it will be Wednesday at 12 a.m. And this is Jagex time I'm talking about. So, once you do that, so back to the matter at hand. Talking to the Navigator will allow you to go through some cutscenes and your tutorial, which is part of the regular comp cape requirement. Going through the tutorial will unlock these your first two ships, your first two captains, and some crewmen. So, before I go any further into that now, every day at 12 a.m., your port will attract 15 crewmen and a captain, and you can access them by using this interface, the crew roster. So, you see I have no captain available for hire, and I have three people here. There's also something at the bottom, which is reroll is available 8. And what you can do is, with the rerolls, is this little green refresh icon. If you click it, it will drop that person off the list, use up one of your rerolls, and put somebody else there that you could possibly actually, you know, use. But you can only have 5 captains at a time, which I've got 5 because I actually had a random the first day that allowed me to pick up 2 extra captains. But there are good captains here and there, you can see. And all of mine are in port right now for the video, of course. And if you want a new captain, you have to dismiss at least one of them first. Also, you can only have 25 crewmen at a time. So, if you actually want to dismiss one, start weeding out the low and replace it with somebody who's actually doing the similar job. So, some captains actually pick up for free. Some actually, well, like some of the crewmen here, you have to pay chimes for. Now, some of them, but it's not really bad. Some good ones, let's see, I think it was Tuankadu Teach. Yeah, it was Tuankadu Teach that was that requested money for me to get him. He was actually really fun. He's actually very good. He costs 100 chime, but what can complain about that? So, first off, you notice that there's like 3 different colors. You see a blue, a red, a green, and then you see some weird ones like brown. And a little bit of purple on this guy. So, the crewmen fall into these color ranges, and red means that they're good with combat. Green means that they have high morale or have a jolly good time. Blue means they're actually sailors who actually know what in the world they're doing, which means they actually have seafaring. And then purple is speed, which you can see from the fireworks enthusiast there. So with these colors, you can actually kind of weed out who you need, and you'll see like you'll have the Varrock Chef, which is pretty good. You have the Traveling Drunk, which is one of the free ones you can get. The Cyclops costs a little bit, and you have to unlock him. Stowaway was free, I believe. If not, he costed 80. So I've went over the rerolls, and you get 12 rerolls a day, along for your well for your 15 crewmen. If you want to get new captains, you have to unlock captain rerolls, and that's an entire different thing. You can also unlock things like reroll visiting adventurer, which the biologist and whaler are an adventurer. So next up, we'll have building. We're going to talk about building upgrades. You'll upgrade your bar and you'll upgrade your office in the tutorial, but things like the workshop, you actually have to explore more islands to unlock the workshop. But the first off, you with refitted lodgings offer a higher percent chance to actually attract quality crew. You can upgrade your shipwright, which boosts your ship stats by 2%, and eventually the highest one being, 10%. It is best to upgrade your warehouse when you can to at least the refitted one, where it'll offer a 3% boost to chime and a 5% boost to bamboo. And when you eventually get to it, you can get a renovated one, which offers a much higher boost. The totem increases the chance of receiving scrollment. The other things with the upgrade buildings will be linked in the description to the official Jagex Wiki, because that one they actually show. So after that, finally we're coming along to voyages, which is the basic thing you're wanting to talk about. So voyages, you'll see here is the top left button. Clicking on that, you'll notice that you have standard voyages and special voyages. Now, the few things you'll notice, like I said, is standard and special, and then you'll notice something with adversity with three bars in this case. The one I want to at least show is Explore the Seas, which only has one bar. Even with the barmaid's tip, you'll see that it has three bars all showing percentages. If you're wanting to take that mission, you need to get these percentages as high as possible or as closest to 100% as possible. And under special voyages, you notice things like the biologist, and there's even one where you can only unlock the scroll from here. So in the one I'm showing, you'll notice that it only has a bar for seafaring, which means morale in combat is pretty much pointless, and the stats that show for it are probably from my current ship. So in this case, we'll be needing seafaring, and your default under edit ship there is that your default thing comes with weather rigging. You can upgrade things, and they'll have a little golden looking padlock beside it, which means you can actually purchase the upgrade. And along with stuff like that, it's really easy to understand. Your rams and figureheads give either combat or morale. Your deck items, which I guess I'll go ahead and get this figured out. Since these two only cover combat morale, you really doesn't matter what you choose for that. Your deck items, you start off with weather rigging, which is offers 100 seafaring. You'll also start off with a crate of food, which is 100 morale. You can unlock sturdy rigging, a large crate of food, and a single cannon within your first couple days. And the cannon is the only thing that right now that's on deck that will actually increase your combat. Now, do note that you have two sets of deck items, so you can actually set both of them up for rigging. So in this case, I'm setting both of mine to sturdy rigging, which increases morale by, or well, in this case, seafaring by 200% or 200. And the hull, there is some that offer, morale or higher seafaring, and the one you want is one that offers the highest chafing possible. Do not worry about the rudders right now, as the rudders only offer speed, and the highest of it being like 1800. So in this case, we have 200, 150, and 200, which means that's 550 seafaring right there. That's just in your ship. But for this, if you hover over your bar at the bottom, you'll notice that I need 2400. This is where your crew comes in. So you click on this little plus sign, and you'll notice for the crew that you can pick a captain and pick the one that has the highest seafaring and just build your crew based on that, remembering that blue is for seafaring. I do recommend actually for your overall crew having a balanced amount. And there are some that have specials, such as the Cyclops and Otteron Storekeeper, that they have their own little ability, which Cyclops has Rallying Cry, which increases experience gains by 10% for your crew. As you can see, you can level up your crew members. The higher level your crew members, the better they are. So at the bottom of the screen, you'll notice that there's a blank spot right around here where the choose option thing is. That's where morale and combat would come in, but since I only need seafaring, it's the showing. It'll also show your success rate, and if you have multiple ones, such as ones covering all three, your lowest percentage one will be your success rate. It's kind of like the Windows Experience Index. So, also, it lists the duration, which is how long it would actually take to do the trip. And the area I'm going to requires an hour and 10 minutes, which is the second area. Trips to the first area, which is the Ark, will take about 35 to 40 minutes. Some of the crew members, like I mentioned, have abilities, like you see Plucky here, which increases his combat. This one has Eagle-Eyed, which increases seafaring. And then there's another, I'm not sure if I have it with that ability yet. Here we are, Eager, which actually increases his morale. So once you max out what you can, go ahead and start the voyage and send it off and wishing them luck. It'll pop up saying the approximate ETA, which is an hour and 16 minutes. And you can then switch over to your next ship and set up your voyage for that. Though, because a lot of these have very high requirements, as you see with the scroll page here, it requires 5,000 seafaring, and you saw the highest I had with my best crew for seafaring was only 1750. So I guess next up we'll talk about the archipelago map. And what it is you see next zone. Within your first 2 days, you should be able to unlock the skull region. And that area is actually pretty interesting because it offers some new items such as gunpowder, as the Ark only, you know, does bamboo. So, once you unlock the second region, you'll unlock something called Port Management. In Port Management, you'll have the option of what you want your crews to search for, specifically. In this case, Moldine would go after Rocktail Soup first, and then eventually I'll move over to Sea Stinger Armor. In the long run, I will finally get all these. And in the description, of course, is that link to the Jagex Wiki, and that will show you things that you can, you know, the requirements to make them. So the next thing that you can scroll over and see is choose where your captain should focus their efforts, which means these are the areas that most of your voyages will come from, meaning that if you really have very low percentage chance and you want some, like, quick cash, etc., stick to the Ark. If you do go to the skull, you will unlock things like gunpowder, and this will also attract crew members from that region. So, it's really an easy thing to see once you unlock the port management. But combining all these together, which the shipyard actually goes along with voyages, because if you click on the shipyard, it'll basically just take you to this the second screen that I've shown you, where you actually just click on edit ship here. You can also open your crew roster here, and choose the thing. Like, you notice that the Eastern Overseer and the Exploding Golem has abilities. Solidarity increases, you know, unique crew members' abilities. And Staunch will mean this Exploding Golem will give his life to save a crewman. Do note that your captain can die on low percentage chance missions. So don't just send one out on 30% and expect him to come back unscathed, because you will most likely either damage the ship, which is a very easy possibility, which even the one I sent out now will be probably damaged when I get it back. So, if you notice that you can finally understand this, it's easy. You can name your ships, but that's honestly really easy to do. And if you have any questions, please leave it in a comment and I will get back to you as soon as I possibly can. I hope you enjoyed and I will see you next time.